is the nature of Adam. The nature of self-survival. The nature of self-understanding. The nature that does things in my own understanding. That's sin. So I'm away from God. I'm away from his plan. So I do not understand. Christ has redeemed me from the curse of the law. The law put a curse on me because the law revealed to me who I really am.
Yes.
Can I stop here? Let me give me 10 minutes because that's too much to preach the whole thing. Let me just deal with this issue right here for you. Do you understand what the church is for now?
Yes.
The Bible says through the law is the knowledge of sin. I'm going to get into what you've been made free from and you should rejoice about it. So, like I said, Paul said I was taking stuff from people before the law came. Mm-hmm. But the Lord told me that was wrong. The Lord exposed to me how far I am away from God's system. So now the law became a curse to me because I'm so used to doing things this way.
Yes.
Just because the law said it, I can't stop.
Yes. My God.
I'm preaching. Please stay focused. I'm used to cussing you out.
Yeah.
The Lord tells me now I'm cursing people out is the wrong thing. But that's not going to make me stop cursing you out. I just not. So now this law that exposed to me my wickedness, that exposed to me my weakness, it has become a curse. Because now I'm guilty and I'm condemned because I can't do it.
Jesus, come on.
Are you hearing me?
Yes.
I'm trying to show you what you're being made free from. Then I'm going to be done. So if the law revealed to me my weakness and my incapabilities, it became a curse to me. Because I can't live by this thing. I'm going to spend my whole life being guilty and condemned. But Jesus came to redeem us from the curse of the law.
Yes, yes, yes.
Which means that the law exposed to me my truth, what my nature is, not as bad, but how it relates to what God wants. I'm preaching good here. God, help me. I'm preaching good here. Jesus, help me. Help me. The Lord does this. It reveals to me my own nature. And how much it is away from God's intended nature. So now the law becomes a curse. Because the Lord trying to make me feel guilty and condemned. The Lord trying to tell me I'm no good. The Lord trying to tell me I'll never make it. Y'all ain't talking to me here. So the Lord now becomes a curse. But Jesus came to redeem me from that curse. How did he do that then? He paid the penalty of sin. And then he gave an example on how to get out.
Jesus.
Pandemo, sir. Yes, Lord. Pandemo. What Jesus did me is he informed me that I had a new nature. As he is, so I'm in the world. He gave me the Holy Spirit. So now I have the Adamic nature that flowed down to Adam, to my father, to me. But now I also have the Christ nature. So now he's telling me, Charles, if you continue in my word, you will learn the truth. I got here by continuing the word that looked like I shouldn't have. I got here by continuing the word when there was no hope. I got here by continuing the word when looking at the word wasn't working. Oh, y'all ain't talking to me here. I got here by continuing the word that made no sense. But he said, Charles, you continue. Then you would know the truth. You would know that you're God's child. You would know that you're an inheritance. You would know that God's accepted you. You would know that you have the Spirit of God dwelling in you. You would know these things. And once you know that, it'll make you free from your own self.
Yeah.
Oh, I lost the whole church. Let me say it again. What happened to all my amens? Let me ask this again. What happened to my amens?
Amen.
Let me say it. Please, hear my heart. I'm on a mission, y'all. I'm on a mission with this. I know what the purpose of the church is. It's to produce sons.
Yes.
And you have to trust God as he's producing. It's God working in you to live into according to his pleasure. But Christ came to make me free not from behaviors. He came to make me free from my nature. There are some things that I did 2 months ago, Dee, that I won't do today. Because I have a revelation.
Yes.
Y'all been talking back to me. Is the desire still there? Yes.
Yeah.
Is the thorn still there? Yes. Is the thorn still trying to convince me I'm going to do it? Yes. But the truth is, I know that that's Adamic nature. I know that's a nature separated from God. And I also know now that Christ has given me a new nature. So if I continue allow, the Bible says, with meekness, receive the grafted word of God, which is able to save your souls. If I keep putting that word in me, it's going to transform me.
Yes. Yes.
Why do I feel like this ain't coming on right?
It is.
If I get tired of being me, if I get tired of myself, if I get tired of being right, if I get tired of being a lie, if I get tired of confusion, if I get tired of arguments, if I get tired of saying I'm sorry another time, then I will receive and meet this, glory to God. The engrafted, you know what I mean? I'll engraft that word in my soul.
Yeah, yeah. All right.
And then that word will tell me, you don't have to do it that way, Charles.
Yeah.
You don't have to respond that way. Did something happen that I lost everybody here?
No.
That word would tell me, you don't have to talk to her, because you can talk to us. Christ talked to her.
Yes.
See, the transformation is not going to happen until you begin to fill your spirit with that word.
Oh, yes.
Because when you get the word in you, the word will dictate behavior to you. And if you continue, that's why I don't understand why people stop coming to church. I kind of understand because we don't tell people the truth.
That's right.
If people knew what I'm telling you today, it'd be hard for them not to come if they receive it.
That's right.
Someone say amen. If they receive what I'm telling you today, if they understood that it's a transformation center, if they don't come here looking for how big the choir is, if people don't go to church looking for how big the choir is, how soft the seats are. If the church would just stop and tell people, when you walk through the door, you come in for transformation.
Yes.
It's my job to produce sons.
Yes.
So I got to talk to you about your humility. I got to talk to you about your love life. I got to talk to you about your character. I got to talk to you about your personality. I got to, oh, y'all didn't see it. I'm getting quiet in here.
Yes. Yes. My Lord.
And before the Lord revealed this to me earlier this morning, I was going to talk to you about being humble. And we will talk about the character of Christ.
Yes.
Be humble. Have faith.
Yes.
Don't manipulate. Don't judge.
That's true.
Amen.
I'm going to start preaching right here this morning. If you love the Lord, say amen.
Amen.
Gentlemen, love, I'm on a mission. And I guess if you connect in the spirit, you can see, you can see what's going on with me. It is my job.
Yes, it is.
It is my assignment to produce sons.
Yes, sir.
That's my assignment. Yes. That's what God gave me to do as an apostle, to seek to get you to the fullness of the stature of Christ.
Yes.
It is my job to pray for you until Christ be formed in you.
Yes.
Y'all not talking to me here. It's my job to tell you to put on the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
It's my job to tell you you have no sin issue with God. It's my job to let you know you don't understand your Adamic nature,
yes,
even though you're saved.
Yes.
It's my job to let you know that you can be transformed by renewing your mind.
Yes.
That you put that grafted word in you, it'll save you from your the soul of your Adamic nature. This is so good, I don't know if anyone can get it.
Yes.
Yes.
It's the gospel of Jesus Christ. I had so many things to say and so much more to say, but we'll get to that as we move along. Because we need to learn. Oh, I don't know who they did. Do you know? Everybody stand up, please. Just stand. I have about 5 more minutes. Just stand.